5, 4, 3, 2, 1. How's life and such, guys?
Pretty good.
I screwed up the music. I'm so sorry.
Well,
I didn't even notice it.
Hello. I accidentally increased the volume and decreased again. Oh, whatever.
Well, it's
Don't worry. It's happened to me many times, Keeney. It's okay.
Yeah, poor LJ.
Yeah, LJ
silly
Pavlo
being all touchy.
But yeah, well. 2 episodes in a row. This one is gonna be good. I can feel it. This is gonna be the best episode we've ever recorded. Actually, probably not. But
you are overly, you're overly optimistic, I think.
That's so. Don't use forced optimism.
Well, I think
for me in the past.
I think Samiki, that you're the opposite of optimistic.
Pessimistic.
That too.
Yeah, well, this is coming from a comic maker, so I can't really trust that.
He's sumistic.
No.
Anyway.
That is just so bad, I can't even imagine. That's just like
I think it was so bad that everybody should put it in their signature.
What? No, don't listen to him. Don't listen to him. But anyway.
Look, if I had the ability to change my name still, I would change it to that.
Oh, right, you can't do that now, can you?
Well, you can do it, like, you know, once a year.
What?
Yeah, you can do it about once a year, as long as it's close enough to your original name. I just like current name too much.
I wanna cry.
Yeah. Well, I hadn't changed my name since... what was it? Toxic Waste Bunny?
Lol, I remember that.
I changed it to Toxic Waste Bunny, yeah. So that's about it.
I haven't changed my name since the day I joined.
You know, it's funny, I used to change my name all the time, but I have not for quite a long time now.
That's Mr. Favor House Atlantic.
Yeah, I remember that. Favor House Atlantic would post comedies and such.
It was interesting.
I used to change my name, like, all the time, to all these weird things. I'm not related to Kuma and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And now I'm just doing variations on Kahinuva. I think I went back to Kahinuva, didn't I?
I think so, yeah.
Because, well, you know, the more you change your name, the less recognized you are, and yada yada yada.
Yeah, that's very true.
Yeah.
Anyway,
well, for me, like, I only changed it back because I wanted to... Never mind.
Speaking of names.
Never mind, it's not important.
We do have
it isn't important. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
I also remember Lies and Slander.
Me too. Lies and Slander are highly suspect.
Man.
Anyway.
With that weird spelling.
And the Shattered Symphony.
Yep. Anyway. Speaking of names and being recognized, I'm Mesnek.
I'm Vardaran.
I'm LJ.
I'm Alina.
Kahi.
I'm Kahi.
I'm Samiki.
And I'm Keeney. And
I'm Keeney. And I'm
lagging out.
He's half a Keeney.
Lagging out. No, okay.
Half.
Let me retry that one, please, please. I'm Keeney.
I am thrilled to be here.
And at this point, I think we can officially upgrade you to a full-time cast member at Vin, considering you've been on 3 episodes in a row, so you're no longer our guest host.
Yeah, I don't know what's wrong with you guys. It's not normal for you to like having me around, but anyway, hi, I'm Venom.
That's the truth.
It is true. That is sadly true.
Yeah. And this is TTV special Toy Fair coverage part 2. No, I'm kidding. We can't do that. I can't cop out for 2 weeks in a row because we're done covering the interesting things. I have no clue what the episode number is.
As per usual.
It was 26, and then we went to 27. I'm not sure. It's going to be the reading so many episodes we recorded.
Well, okay, let's look at it this way. What's the date today?
The TTV episode 2/25/26/2012.
Okay.
That's a lot.
Yeah, yeah, we'll go with that for now. I'll find out the correct number when I upload it, but anyway.
Yep.
Okay, so this week we're going to be back to our regularly scheduled segments, as I promised. Last week, no more Toy Fair, even though there is more Toy Fair, but I don't think you guys want to talk about Friends and Duplo, do you?
Yeah, no.
Not really.
Oh, Friends, guys, let's talk about Friends.
No.
Friends is my favorite line.
There's too much pink in that one thumbnail.
Too much for your liking.
They have pink disease. They don't like pink.
Okay, something about Friends. I missed last week's episode because I actually went to the Legoland Discovery Center up in Chicago. I was just sitting around the store. Nah, I know, right? So I'm just sitting around the store, and it turns out that, like, there's, you know, a couple of the girls there, and they're just crying, and they're really, you know, they just want to go home, basically, while they're never doing stuff. So, but her mother took her over to the Friends, and she soon quieted down and soon bought a set from there. So initially, I was opposed to it, but I guess it is getting some audience out there, so.
Yeah, if it works, it works.
Some girls to Lego. Yeah.
Yep. So, like, and this really isn't that the whole purpose? So.
Yeah. Yeah.
I guess
somewhere
doing it
to get it. Yeah.
Well, we can talk about it a little if you want in the news, which is the next segment coming up.
Oh dear. News.
Oh fun, the news. I should probably load on BZPower. Alright, where are we starting off from?
Just start off from Monday.
From Monday, okay. Which Monday, February 20th, okay. In the news this week, we have SetView 30057 Anakin's Pod Racer. Toy Fair 2012 Friends and Games. Toy Fair 2012 Star Wars Cars and SpongeBob. Toy Fair 2012 Technic and More. Lego unveils Sydney Opera House. Interview with game developer. Toy Fair 2012 Sydney and the Rest. Phyoohrii's Opus. Reminder, short stories contest number 9, In the Darkness Bind Them. Avenger sets for the pre-order on TRU.com. New LEGO survey. TRU sells for the week. And set review 6227 Breeze. And that is the news and commentary.
But there was no commentary.
There was no commentary.
That's just what it says at the top. I just read that.
It always says that to people.
News and commentary.
Commentary starting now, if ever.
Yeah, I suppose that's true.
It's like a joke, because it says news and commentary at the top.
Yeah, here's my commentary. Phyoohrii's thing is amazing.
Yeah.
Phyoohrii.
Whatever his name is. I'm gonna call him...
It's quite amazing.
I haven't looked at it. Let me look at it now.
Yeah, basically... he took 432 biological characters, made PowerPoint illustrations of them and put them all on bookshelf.
My favorite one by him is Gerbrad.
Yeah,
jabs at the other random projects that have popped up over the years, because unlike many ambitious projects that have been attempted, this one was completed.
Yeah, I swear.
Oh, that sounds familiar.
I took that as a personal hit to the gut for a certain couple of letters that start with a B, end in the middle with an N, and end with a B.
Oh, shut up.
Okay. Remember, that feeling of being kicked in the gut may just return.
It may just return.
That, and I swear, it's like, Chronicles, Book of Chronicles. They're shouting to us. They're saying
Chronicles, Chronicles. Yeah.
By the way, it is absolutely spectacular, and I was following the time he was working on that on a site, you know, DeviantArt, and it's absolutely amazing. He's been working on it for about 7 months.
Yes.
So.
It's quite good. And, you know, on the, on the actual news this week, there's... do you guys want to skim over the rest of Toy Fair, or is there any interest at all?
No interest, unless we want to talk about Fred.
Well, I mean, there is the Technic, and there is Star the Wars. City, but I don't, you know.
I suppose they could have had Star Wars. But,
or Star Wars.
I don't feel like doing the pictures supplement.
Oh,
and,
but don't forget, guys, Star Wars and all of the famous lines aren't even the highlight of Brick Fair. We got SpongeBob sets again.
Oh,
yay!
Toy Fair, not Brick Fair.
Toy Fair. Dutchman and the, SpongeBob's for the win. It's be the best. All that good stuff.
SpongeBob SquarePants. SpongeBob SquarePants.
No, don't do that.
It's be the best.
My cousin still watches that. I mean, it's just so annoying.
Yeah,
SpongeBob SquarePants.
I thought we were mature.
No.
LJ, okay, how long have you known us?
I was about to say to an extent.
To an extent. No. How long have you known us? Come on, dude.
Maturity and TTV in the same sentence just don't go together. In fact, if you do put them in the same sentence together without saying not in the middle, you have a catastrophic event that just happened. You see, right now on the other side of the earth, something just blew up, and there are tons of people in the hospital.
My
right
hometown.
Now.
It's like dividing by zero.
Your hometown.
Yes, it's perfect.
Wow, it's dwa. This is horrible.
But yeah, there's nothing really much to go with Brick Fair now.
Toy Fair, not Brick Fair. Brick Fair is in August. Toy Fair is in February.
That too.
Yeah, anyway. Well, something that actually is interesting is that BZP will be conducting an interview with one of the game developers of the game Breakout. And trust me, we're not done talking about this. Though, I guess we could go ahead and talk about it right now, because it is related.
I'm interested in seeing what he has to say. Because, oddly enough, the guy, the company that, that made this game also made some of the old Bionicle games, too.
What?
Made, a Gory Defense, and they made a Mari game, they made the, the Battle for Power, I think. I'm not sure.
Those were good games!
They were okay arcade games, but, doing a 3D is something that I'm not sure would be the best move for them.
Yes. Be the best. Be the best. Yes.
Be the best arcade game.
Those games were be the best.
Those were good games.
Be the best.
Yeah, okay.
But yeah, so, Kai, do you want to go ahead and talk about this right now or save it for brought to attention? Because we have a couple things to say about this group.
Whatever you guys want.
I'd say wait until brought to attention.
Agreed. I've just noticed something, that this is not all the news. This wasn't all the news. Something happened in GD recently, not to be tooting my own horn or something.
What are you talking about?
Yeah.
I don't know.
They changed the color of my name, and it's not to pink,
Oh, yeah.
Dang it! Dang it!
Well,
oh, right, they changed it back from orange to black, because you lost your OBDPC.
Wait, what? You lost your what? Did I hear that right?
All right.
And technically, I did lose it, but I upgraded it.
Oh, well, no, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
Did you upgrade it to a premier outstanding BZP citizen or what?
Yeah, I was already that. I post ridiculous stuff in my blog already, and I have for a while, but you know.
Well, trust me, Samiki, we weren't gonna ignore you. We totally didn't forget about anything that is important.
We would never forget about something that important.
Yep, Samiki got friends! Okay, let's move on.
Yeah, right. I got. Like, you know, I wouldn't. I wouldn't trust you as far as I could throw you, and I certainly wouldn't throw you with a 10-foot pole. And I think I just mixed some metaphors there.
Throw you with a 10-foot pole?
Yeah, it's called lacrosse. It's called lacrosse.
Anyway, no. Yeah, what happened, GD?
I just linked you.
Yes. Our very own Sumiki is now a staff member.
No!
And Elgin screams.
I can't announce that Sumi can easily get the higher ups to ban him now.
No.
Lol.
No, look, I replaced Velox. That's all. So that's my claim to fame. There's no one else who got promoted, so I'm the only guy who's. I'm the noob who's getting picked on by everybody.
Yep. You mean you're the only one who was willing to take on the job?
No, I was. Look, I only got asked. I don't know who else was asked, if anybody.
Velox got promoted.
Yes, and Kini replaced it. Not Kini. Lol, I keep confusing you guys' names. Kini and Sumiki.
Kini's Canadian.
How can you confuse our names? Only the end is even slightly similar.
Sumiki. You know, but yeah, Sumiki got promoted, so we now have a staff member on our podcast.
I got promoted.
Thing. Lol.
No, you didn't.
I wish.
You're my awesome powers.
Host unapproving.
I don't fear the staff.
No, I swear, I think after the last 4 days, Mickey, you're the only one who's been able to make unapproving posts sound like a kitten hissing at me.
I think the only person who can sound like being promoted is an insult.
Yes. Yeah. What can you even do?
I can unapprove posts. I can approve posts. I get to PM noobs about how they're bad.
Well, approve this. Right. Jump. I don't approve of you. Ooh.
Come on, podcast.
And what was that, Elena?
Sounds boring.
Lol. Well, regardless, it's still a very good accomplishment, and we're all happy for you.
Are we?
Most of us. Yeah, most of us.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, congrats and whatnot.
So, are we moving on to something more interesting?
Well, I think there was one more thing in the news I wanted to talk about. I'm struggling to remember what it was before we moved on.
Obviously,
you're a breeze.
I was just about to say.
Yeah. So this is the other fabled set. Which is only released in Europe and will not be released in the US till summer. So, it has a very interesting build, but I like how it looks. And the energy shield is good, and the swords are good, and it's good. She has back armor, and that's cool. And
Samus Aran 2.0.
Yep.
Why is her knees supposed to like that?
What do you mean?
Why are her knees bent like that in the picture? Are they supposed to be like that?
Why are her knees bent?
Oh, bent backward?
Yeah, they're kind of bent backwards.
Actually, yeah, no.
Yeah, it's just interesting posing.
Okay, good. I was wondering why it was like that. Yeah, she looks like a pretty good overall set. She's my second favorite next to, with this face.
Rocka.
Rocka, I always forget his name for some reason. I keep thinking Goldo or something like that.
Goldo? What?
Wow, just wow.
Goldfinger!
You know, I just have to ask.
With a Midas touch.
I just have to ask, though. In this one picture of Breeze and Thornraxx, why? What is going on with the Thornraxx launchers?
Well, obviously, Thornraxx is like, ooh, I finally found a mate! And he's making out with Breeze's cannon, who he doesn't realize that cannon can fire into his mouth and he'll soon be dead.
Because Thornraxx is a... Yep.
Forever alone, Thornraxx is gonna be forever alone.
Forever alone in Europe. Yes.
It's a shame, because that's the set I really want most, because of the new teal. I may have mentioned that before, but the teal is the teal.
Medium azure. But yes.
Screw you, it's new teal.
Breezes. Yeah. She's fun fact. She's the only hero in the winter wave of breakout to have two hands.
Wow.
Everyone else just has what, a one stump or something?
Yeah, or just a socket joint. Yeah.
Well, so, gun hand.
Yeah. Alright, so and then I guess there is one more interesting thing, and that's the finalized Avengers set pictures on ToysRUs.com.
Woohoo, Avengers!
Where you can clearly see for the first time the mysterious enemies from the movie that they didn't want to spoil, so they whited out the box art at Toy Fairs. These mystery dudes are finally revealed to the public, and wow, they spoiled the movie for me. I'm never going to be able to enjoy the Avengers when it comes out now that I know these people are in it.
Aliens are yellow.
I don't even know who they are!
Wait, Kahi.
They don't look like anything I've seen in a Marvel comic before.
Yeah, I agree.
I'll post... Yeah, there's a picture I'm looking at. It's lols.
Watch, I bet you they're the what's his name? I can't even remember.
Never heard of that.
Like, you know, the in the Green Lantern movie, the bad guy, or the leader.
This is Marvel, not DC.
I know, I
Come on,
don't
have
really.
Respect, alright?
I don't.
Yeah.
I don't like comics. Watch, but come on, you never know, they could just be stupid and decide to combine comic continuities, even though it makes no sense to do so and would never work.
You just said is the equivalent of saying, hey, isn't that mutant Tahu, you know, from X-Men? That's the equivalent of what you're saying right now.
No.
The robot mutant from an alien.
From
the Transformers. I guess Transformers would be a better allegory here.
But yes, they look interesting. The only things that are different is that you can finally see Hulk's face, and the mysterious aliens are revealed for the first time. The Quinjet aerial battle is now an actual battle, as Vin noted on last week. It's not even a battle, but now it is. So. It's great. And unless you have any opinions on those sets or anything else in the news, I suppose that wraps it up.
Nope.
Well, nope. What can you do? Rather quick news segment, but oh well. I guess that does enable us to propel ourselves forward into the next segment. Everyone, I'm Masanak, obviously, because I already said this earlier in the podcast, and let us dive into what's going to be brought to attention today. Well, we're actually going to be talking about two different things in this segment. One very important and one semi-important thing, which has been going on in our lives as of recent, even though one of the things has not been going on in our lives at all. It's just a random article on a random website, but we'll get to that. We're going to start off with the most important thing first, which is some changes that we have recently made to our podcast structure, hosting, and all that fun stuff. And, well, let's put it this way. If you're listening to this episode, you know what the changes are. Because, well, it directly involves how you're going to be able to listen to our podcast episodes, where we put them, etc. And that is obviously the switch to hosting our episodes on YouTube via Lego Rebrick. And I guess you couldn't call it a loophole because we did get permission from the staff to do this, but it is a, what's the proper wording? It's not a way around because we got approval from the staff to do this. Okay, let's put it this way. We aren't permitted to host our episodes on YouTube and put them on Lego Rebrick which allows us to both have a presence on BZP, because Rebrick, being an official LEGO site, has gotten clearance from staff to be posted about. Because they moderate their content, so if there's anything inappropriate, Rebrick will filter it out. That's Black Six's logic. Which means that we are able to host our podcast episodes on YouTube, upload them to our Three Virtues channel, where we have all of our BioCraft-related stuff. And, well, hopefully you guys who are listening to this are enjoying it, because, well, let's put it this way. This is the whole purpose of doing it. We want to expand our reach. We want to reclaim some of our fan base, which we lost when BZP went down for half a year and kind of robbed us of any name notoriety we had. And, well, it's also a much better way to host our episodes than what we were having to do previously, uploading it to GoDaddy, which was not a good experience. And then yeah, I know. It was, you know, that was a bad experience. And then scrambling to find another place to put them and upload them to Mediafire just so we can get them out every week. But it's the basics of what we're doing. For now, everything will remain the same, though there may be a couple changes coming in the future, or there may not. Everything could remain exactly as it is now. I guess time will tell. So, what are you guys' opinions on the new Switch?
I think it's a good idea. That's all I really think.
It was my idea, so it's a good idea.
It was partially your idea, amigo.
I think it's good, because, I mean, like you said, we've lost a lot of our fan base, and BZPower's fan base in general is pretty much gone as well through the downtime. So, I mean, it's good that we can kind of branch out and, you know, get more people interested. And we can actually talk about YouTube now.
Yes.
I know, right? Wait.
No, don't you mean that certain video website that a lot of people know about?
Yeah,
I think it's a great idea. Hopefully.
Well, I was initially reluctant to do it, as I know some of you were, because it kind of represents that, okay, we have to kind of change the way we do things, incorporate pictures and slideshows into the podcast, making it less of a podcast and more like, you know, well, that kind of like a video or whatever. However, it's kind of harkening back to our old advanced podcast days when we tried that and only did it for like one episode on Podomatic. Oh, those were the days. I remember those days. They were horrible.
Yeah, with psycho chihuahuas. What the Kurzani? Where did you even find that picture, Mark?
Wait, what picture?
It's like a psycho red-eyed chihuahua going.
That wasn't me. That was Tom.
Yes.
You know, how did that make so much sense now?
Get to the chopper.
Yes.
To the chopper.
No.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Well, basically, what we're gonna do.
I'm glad to let us reach two audiences. I think that's amazing. It helps us to expand. So past the BZPower fan base, so we can still reach those guys, but we can also reach a whole new audience on YouTube.
Yes.
And it's much more convenient for people to listen to our episodes and stuff.
Yes.
Yeah.
And, you know, hopefully we can continue doing things exactly how we do them, and it's not going to interfere with any of our other projects or whatnot. We are just going to keep doing what we've always done for around 3 years now, I'd say. And, well, we hope you guys enjoy it. And we'll see where things go from here. And all that fun stuff. So,
yep.
Unless you guys have anything else to add, we'll jump right into our next topic of discussion, which is interesting to say the least. Okay, so earlier on the news, we briefly talked about how BZP is going to have an interview with one of the creators of the Hero Factory Breakout game, and they were going to ask him a bunch of questions, like probably a bunch of generic questions asked by the members. Like, oh, how did you first get into game design? What's your aspiration for game design? I read the topic, and I saw no questions about Breakout, the actual game. So, maybe there have been some since I last checked, but regardless.
I just checked it just now.
Very good, very good. That's a good thing. So, regardless, I recently stumbled upon an article, which I am currently trying to find and actually relink for all of you for the sake of, you know, having it for reference. And it was basically one of the people that worked on the Breakout commenting about the game and talking about the game to a certain degree. And the reason that it kind of bugs me is because we have talked about Breakout in depth in the past. Kahi over here has actually done a Let's Play of Breakout on another channel of ours, name unavailable. And he kind of disagrees with some of the stuff these guys are saying in this article. So, I'm going to let him do some talking for a while. And here is the link. So, yeah.
Alright. It's hosted at Game at Sutra, which we can actually mention now. Getting into the freedom. Which is a, I guess it would be, how popular would you say it would be? It is a pretty high profile game website.
Yes.
Yeah. It's on, you know, so. But I guess the main thing that came here was like how they're basically praising this game as like the newest innovation in browser based, you know, browser based computing, I guess. No. I just have to say, no way.
No way
at all. First off, all right, there's this thing here that says the controls are intuitive. They're not. They're missing like a basic function of a lot of, you know, third-person shooters. They don't have, like, you know, we've been playing Mass Effect. Everybody here, we play Mass Effect 3. The demo just came out. We play multiplayer. We do stuff like that. All right, it's a really great third-person shooter. One of my favorites. It's the best. But the thing with the Hero Factory is that the controls are so off sometimes that you can't. It's hard to aim. It's hard to fire where you're aiming at. I guess would be the best way to say it. There's no real place to aim. You can't, there's no lock-on key that you can try to strife around your enemies. And especially if you're running away from something, you cannot sort of swivel around and turn back at the last second. You know, just try to see it. You just have to. The camera is very far off. I think the biggest thing is the camera issues. And there are a ton of bugs in the game. And in the Let's Play I did, there's one I got stuck into a wall, one where the camera didn't follow me. I mean, even Meso, I don't think you even got past the first level, have you? Have you gotten, were you stuck in that one position before you get the hamburger? The hamburger. I've never seen anything like that.
Here's the thing that I have to say about this game real quick. There's a bug in it for me, and others have had it, so it's not just like me being weird or whatever. I've seen numerous reports of this in the BZP topic for the game, as well as the Eurobricks topic for this game and all that fun stuff. It is basically a bug directly after where you go to upgrade your gun for the first time, to blast through a wall, and this is on the first level, keep in mind. First level. And, I upgrade my gun, and I get teleported back to this wall. And I've seen Kahi's LP. I'm supposed to click, 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 hit the wall, shoot through it, and it'll burst apart and allow me to progress. It does not even recognize me as being there. It doesn't. It recognizes me as still being in the other screen, and it does not transition properly. So I'm standing there. The game doesn't realize I'm there, so it doesn't give me the option to click and shoot through the wall, and I'm stuck there, and there's nothing I can do. I can just stare at the wall as this icon spins around for 10 minutes, and I'm trying everything I can possibly do. I'm clicking, I'm bringing up the menu. The game hasn't froze because I can still bring up the menu. I just cannot break through this wall, and I've tried it 6 different times now on 3 different browsers. It doesn't work.
Wow.
That's the big thing about this. There are a lot of bugs, especially when it was first released. There's a lot of bugs, and I think they fixed them. When I first played, there was. You said now they have a sort of walk-on key now? To shift?
Yeah, shift basically not only locks on, but it also refocuses your camera.
Yeah. Alright, so that's a bit of an improvement, but even still, it's not where, you know, this is not the game you want to put as a poster boy for, like, this is where 3D games are headed. Towards, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's not even a creative game. Like, the game, the article notes that, you take your hero, you go through all these different worlds, and you go all through different places. Except for one notable level, which I know in the LP. All the others are really generic or just poorly done. A lot of them are just boring, the same old thing over and over again. It's just, you know, not actually different. There is one level, and I think it's the one where I have to, you go through the jungle. That level is very well done. It has different, it has different textures. It has two different parts. So if you go from the jungle into like a temple sort of, into like a arena for the final battle. That is very well done. The others are just plain boring. They all have the same textures everywhere. You don't really go to a lot of places that are remotely new. It's just very repetitive and very dull. It's not like it was built for originally for a Mac or on a Mac, I have to say. That's why whenever you capture someone or when you defeat Black Phantom in the original game, you go it says hit return in order to handcuff him. If you are a kid, and most kids have Windows, right? All right, and you say, you just defeated Black Phantom, all right, and you fought all this time, maybe you died a couple times, or you defeated him, and you need to handcuff him, and it says, press return. What?
Yeah, what? It's quite interesting. You can tell they didn't really make this game with a lot of foresight into, their target audience. So.
And I guess it's understandable. This is the company's, I looked at their portfolio. For Lego, and I think it's one of theirs. They're one of the first 3D games, right? I can get that there's going to be some bugs and stuff. And, for a kid's website, sure, Factory Breakout, it's not too bad. It's easy. It was better than I thought it was going to be. And it's free to play online. It's better that way. But, this article just, it's like putting it on this pedestal. This is what we're all heading towards. This is what online gaming is going to be like. We're doing stuff we've never thought possible. We're breaking new ground and doing this online. Yep. Yeah, we're doing it. We're making all this design, and we've got this awesome controls, and kids can pick it up, and they can play it, and it's the best thing out there now. It's not. That's like overrating it to the max.
Yep. I don't even get this game.
So many doubles.
I just want to play the game. I'd like to play it for once, but I can't because of the stupid glitch, which I do not think they will ever patch, because while I don't imagine bug fixes are too easy to do on this kind of game, which doesn't have an interface for doing such a thing. Yep.
That's one of the questions I was trying to ask in the talkback topic. I was going to ask I asked, how long, how do you know if players are having problems with a certain glitch or bug, and, how often we get to fixing them? Even though glitches are going to happen for every computer, there's going to be someone somewhere is going to have a problem with it. But I guess if it's so widespread, because Messi, you said you've seen others have it. If it's so widespread, someone should be doing something about it. It should be a patch. They should be working on fixing it.
Yeah, well, maybe they'll fix it in the summer update, perhaps. I don't know.
Oh, hamburgers.
Hamburgers.
Stupidest thing. Ever. Robots do not eat hamburgers. I don't know why they even have hamburgers as a power-up on the thing. I don't think they work
for a hamburger.
Yeah.
No,
I guess
I give you a hamburger.
They're part of power-ups. They're sunglasses, those fake disguises of the nose and the mustache. There's an iPod, or an MP3 player. There's a hamburger, and there's some other things that just are really out of place in the world. I almost just think that he just had, the Lego came up to him and said, here's the heroes, here's the villains, have them fight somewhere.
Well, see, it worked in Creep Crushers. Did you ever play the Creep Crushers games?
No, I didn't.
Ah, you should one of these days. Well, in the Creep Crushers games, you were chibis, and you were fighting the villains who were also chibis. Every time you killed one of them, they exploded into cheeseburgers and sunglasses and iPods and whatnot, and they thought that they would put that into Breakout, even though it's so different of a game.
What?
Yeah,
I don't know. I give you a hamburger.
I can't tell if you're joking or not.
I'm not joking.
Tell if you're joking or not.
I'm not.
That is so off the wall.
I'll give you a video when we're done with this.
It's like, It's like that one Bionicle game, right? When you're
yes.
That one we played on the media project, when you're supposed to shoot these guys,
yep.
And all these weird enemies just chopping
Bionicle
up at you.
Bionicle Attic Media. A work
yeah,
of art.
Attic Media.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Yeah.
But yeah, right. I suppose this wraps it up. This article is... I suppose the game is not completely worthless, but as it stands, it's definitely not up to the level of revolutionary gameplay and control schemes and blah, blah, blah that they're praising it as. The graphics aren't even that good. And they say it looks and feels like a AAA console title. Well, no, it doesn't. Anyway.
I'm playing a AAA console title right now. And I have seen the stuff they do with Phyoohrii. It's not. I know what you're talking. By talking AAA, do you mean like a movie adaptation of the game?
Yes.
Which I guess this sort of is. You know, it's a movie adaptation of Phyoohrii Factory Breakout. So, it's like all movie games are. Terrible in quality, terrible in controls, really generic, and nothing new about them. Basically a waste of money.
Yep.
They're just trying to cash in on the franchise. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, that sums it up.
Game so worthless it practically runs on AAA batteries.
LOL.
Wow.
That's lols.
Dun dun but, dun.
I suppose that now that these two topics have been brought to attention, we can wrap this segment for next week and move on to the spotlights.
Holy cheese, I need to find one.
All right. Yeah. Well, Jay, you're up.
All right. Let's see. I already have one right here. I've linked the comic I'm going to be tearing shreds right there.
Oh, gosh. That doesn't sound good.
Oh, then.
okay. I can just guess.
All right, and here we go. Fun episode today. I'm going to be talking about a comic maker I think I've talked about before. We talked about his comic in the Advent Calendar episode. You all know him. You all, you know, are acquaintances with him. Yeah, indifferent. Dr. Giggles, Nubicorn King, made the comic topic Alien Abduction. First thing you see when you come into this topic is a poster that says Alien Abduction coming soon. And it looks actually really nice. It doesn't look that bad at all. Very quickly, Dr. Giggles' Nubicorn King is a steel visionary with 355 posts. It's been here for about a year. Let's go to his first comic, which is, mind you, the only comic linked to the first post. But if you scroll down, you see, wait for it, three other comics that have not been linked to the first post. Which is odd. Normally
Brothel.
You link comics to the first post every time you make a new comic. But regardless, I'm going to go primarily over the first comic. I have a real bone to pick with this one. So it starts off, and apparently this is set in the year 2022. About... Yeah. And an entirely new cast of characters, and and so it's like he's starting anew. So the first two panels show him with in a very well-made background. You know, it looks almost photorealistic, and nice brick background, nice window. The only problem is the blatantly obvious sprite-made couch in the middle of the room!
Which he didn't even make.
Yep, which he didn't even make. But it looks good. Then you go down and see the next two panels, which are outside with absolutely no reason as to why, following a blue character going, "What a nice day for a walk." And she turns to the side and it goes right back to Dr. Giggles. That just right. No relevance at all. Just my signature showing off the background, and no one cares about it.
Wow.
We go over to Dr. Giggles inside his house, and he's going, oh, okay, holding up a phone. How did we get here? Where did the phone come from? Who is he talking to? Why is he saying, I'll be there soon in the next panel? And then the scene switches to either another part of the house or a different building that looks like a part of the house or a few feet from him in the same house. It's like a front door. Here you have these two people. One of them is this very bright pink going, okay, good. He'll be here soon. What? And that's the end of the
film. Okay. Ooh. It's funny because it's funnier if you try to read it as a very serious comic.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'll be there soon. Okay, good. He said he'll be here soon.
What is the point of this comic? I don't understand it.
Don't you see? He'll be there
soon.
What
a nice day for all.
I don't understand why he made this. It doesn't make any sense.
Okay, I'm reading this comic, and after reading it, the only thing that is stuck in my head, the thing that's imprinted most upon me, is that he's going to be there soon. And I now want to find out what happens when he gets there, and if it really was soon.
There's such repetition, too. It's like, oh, okay, I'll be there soon. Okay, good, he'll be here soon.
Well, if there's one thing he's accomplished with this, it makes me want to read the next comic to find out if he's there.
I'm not much of a comic maker, but this makes me cringe. Sorry, just saying.
Yeah.
It looks like it's a spinoff of his primary series, which I guess you'd have to read first to understand who these characters are. But still, what a nice day for a walk. It's good and healthy.
What is up with that? But anyway, yeah. So in the next comic...
Nothing, just keep on.
In the next comic, major improvement. You can see the panels are larger. Actually, the sprites are larger.
Oh, yeah.
And guess what? The blue character is back from a great walk!
Which is good, because at least now we're establishing relevance and whatnot.
This might annoy Kai to some extent, but the text bubbles, the text is touching the text bubbles rim.
that always gets me. I don't know why no one has ever just, you know, figured it out. Yeah, text touching the border does not look good whatsoever. No exceptions.
So,
the bubbles will surround the text.
This comic is actually, while it's an improvement, it just kind of repeats the same thing.
I love that car, the way he did that.
Just do it. So, apparently, we have...
LJ, link it.
Oh, I linked the topic, which has all the comics.
Yeah, but they're not, like, at the front. You have to scroll down through everything to find them. It'd be nice.
Yeah, also scroll down through everything to find them. Okay.
Where's three?
Cool.
There's two in there. Mm-hmm. Four. So anyway, here you have Dr. Giggles talking to the Miss Walkity Walk Random Walk, going, who wanted us to come to her house? For what? What for? I'm not sure. So after that long discussion in very large text for no reason, we have one panel. One panel of the purple and pink characters looking off to the side. What is the relevance?
Why are you screaming?
So
what do you have to say?
LJ is passionate about his comics, yo.
Yeah, I know. I'm like,
I noticed.
The story is a mess, but it's not like LJ screaming at, like, you know, it's one of the comics that we saw, like Purox comics from the Advent calendar.
This one, comics made sense.
This one is just, the story's all over the place, but I find it, in terms of, you know, the presentation can be better, it's okay as far as a comic series. There are some merits to it.
But like Mesa put, at least what he's successfully doing is getting people to wait for the next comic to see what's happening.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. It looks like he did get there soon after all.
Yep. So, by the way, my screaming is just for theatrics. Not that angry. While these comments make almost no sense whatsoever, the graphics are actually not that bad. I really do like that background. And he did a really good job with the objects.
The background impresses me to no end.
Yeah, I don't know if he made that or his older brother Vitaki did or what, but I don't know. So they get in the car and they get here. And here's what confuses me. It's the front of the same brick building and there's a bunch of gray stuff. What's with the gray stuff? What is the gray stuff?
It's supposed to be stairs, I guess.
Stairs? It looks like asphalt.
Yeah, asphalt stairs, yo.
It makes sense, doesn't it?
Asphalt stairs.
I gotta say, I don't like the look of the randomly completely photorealistic car.
I like the car, kinda, to an extent.
it doesn't fit the style of the rest of the comic.
Mm-hmm. So finally, they all meet up, and they figure out what's going on. Apparently, the pink one said, "My horoscope said something bad is going to happen soon." There's a brief pause, and we confirm that the pink deck leaves it. So here we are going, what's going to happen?
Yeah, now I want to find out what happens next, so I'm going to go back to the topic.
Dramatic music!
Yeah. I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to click it. Next comic.
The third comic basically gets everything set up. They get some more characters in, and repeat the same, and you believe it, joke. No, that's fine. But my favorite panel out of this is the last one. Hey, Lulu, what supply do we need?
Guns. Lots of guns.
Guns, lots.
Guns, lots. Yes, the only problem is there's no space. There's no comma. There's no period between guns and lots. So that
guns, lots and lots of guns.
It's guns, lots and lots of guns. So I don't know what a guns lot is.
I get the gun slot.
So, final comment.
It sounds like dubstep. Gun slot.
Then the final.
Wub 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 bounce bounce wub wub wub. Anyway.
So finally,
well, not
I'll
the emoji
be there soon.
The fourth comic, and as of the time of this recording, the last one so far, Dr. Giggles denounces the use of guns, and so they don't use guns. And they all decide they should stay here for the night, even though those windows show it is a bright blue day.
I saw that too. I was like, "We should stay here tonight." And it's like noon outside.
A wild storm.
Bit of a derp there. It's all right. So
this is nonsense.
And so Giggles goes, "What will you say?" So they all wait. Whoa! Here it says, "So Sally, Giggles, and the rest of Lulu's friends went back to their houses to get their things." And then they came back! What was the point? What was the point?
The point is the anger LJ.
Oh, it's working! But final panel, it's meant to be night. And then here you got this creepy orange guy going, "There are no such things as monsters."
I see.
Look at that. This actually makes me want to see the next one now.
Okay.
his comics are addicting, you have to admit it. They might not be like a directorial mastery or anything, but they're addicting.
I want to read this. Make the next comic, Dr. Giggles. I am now a devoted follower of yours.
So, basically,
it's like Transformers movies, you know? Like, they're not anywhere near...
but Transformers movies are like entertaining.
Another one comes out. Yeah. This one, it's entertaining. It's something about it. I can't really put my finger on it.
Is it so bad?
Robots beating each other up. Yeah.
I'm probably gonna post later on.
Yeah.
Me too.
So, in retrospective, these are not bad comics by any meaning of the imagination. If you're looking for, fair graphics. The graphics are not that bad. He does need a little bit of work with photorealism and I would suggest some different angles for things and some panel continuity, like a nice day for a walk. But it seems that these are a large improvement from things he's done in the past, and definitely have the potential to be something up to the level of his older brothers or even beyond that. My main problem with this is story continuity, spelling, and
large text.
The large text and the speech bubble clipping and stuff.
Yeah, it's all down to presentation. It's the pacing of the story and like how he adds stuff and takes away stuff, and like I think he has the story down in his mind. He has problem putting it onto an actual canvas.
Yeah.
That's where all these things, like, you know, what a nice day for a walk. It would probably make sense. It makes sense to him. He's not getting it well, you know, put on there. So I'd say work on that. Work on really getting what you want on the panel so everybody is on the same page with you.
Yeah.
Work on coherency, basically.
Yeah,
absolutely. Coherency, that's the word.
That would make these very, very good comics. Definitely also find a couple of tutorials and guides for proper speech bubble use, and you should be pretty good there. And then finally, guns. You need
yes.
guns.
Gun slots and lots of guns.
So I definitely say the pros of these comics are, you know, its graphics and its addictive nature, because you're going to get a lot of followers if you keep doing yes. what you're doing right now. But again,
like a retailer store for like gun-related things. Gun slots. We sell guns of all types. AK-47s and et cetera.
Yeah. So, absolutely. Not bad comics, just need a bit of work. So, yes. Yeah, definitely go check them out. Alien Abduction by Dr. Giggles, Nubicorn King. And that's Comic Maker Spotlight.
All right.
Woohoo. Sweet.
Well, now that that is done, we can move on to our final...
To our final segment of the day.
Spotlight. The MoC Spotlight. So...
And this is the MoC Spotlight. Today, I'm reviewing The Citrus Ray by Fenrai, known previously as, I think, Sir Fenrock. So he recently returned to the forums after being away for a while, and this is actually coincidentally an entry for my blog contest, which is called Fresh Salad. And this is basically, the point is you have to build something and there has to be a fruit in it. Yes, a fruit or a vegetable. It has to be some sort of food related product that has to be built in to the creation, whatever it is. A ray gun, and it uses a clementine, which, for those who are unaware, it is essentially a small orange. And it's basically, it's got, that's all the much is to it as far as the theme goes. But the execution of it, I really like the gun part on the end. And I've rooted it in the topic, but I wanted to use this chance to go into a little more in-depth right here. The front of it uses Hero Factory parts with a triaxle, so that just really gives a nice kind of evil-ish gun vibe about it. And the silver is used all over to give it a very mechanical feeling. There's enough black in it to make it sinister, so the control of colors is pretty good. Now, speaking of the colors, there are two colors that don't really fit together. That would be the orange and the trans red, one-by-one circular plate. Or is that... Yeah, that's a plate. That's not a tile. And I've thought that it would be a lot better if that was replaced with a trans orange little thing. Because, you know, it would make more sense and it would flow better with the colors. So if you have an orange, you got an orange fruit, it shoots out orange stuff. Thought that actually made kind of sense. Maybe he doesn't have any, but I'm not going to hold that against him because it's really the only aberration in the color scheme that I can find. The base is used... Well, actually, I'm just looking at some pictures here. Towards the back, there's also some... There's a trans red Borak eye. So that could have been replaced with a trans orange one, I guess, or even a silver one, if necessary. And, let's see... The main body of the gun, the ray, uses the textures of the old tubes as well as the Mari tubes that are twisted around it. Now, I've seen a lot of twisted Mari tubes to give an effect to these sorts of things recently, mostly from arms, just arms hanging down, make it look really weird. So people have been using that recently, but this is the first time I've seen it actually on a gun. It makes it all sinister and makes it look like it's been cobbled together by some mad scientist, which what have I created? But anyway, moving on. I noticed that there was a use of two Mari tubes, silver ones, through the Mari Torn blades in the apparatus that holds the Clementine itself. And so that gives a nice little overall texture to that, which is something that can't really be achieved when you're talking about just trying to build with regular parts. You have to have some sort of flexibility to the parts to get that effect. And so that's a really nice effect he's got going there. I've tried things like that before. They don't usually end up working. So, but it looks like he has used some small Technic parts in order to secure it down to the bottom. And with the bottom, it's really solid. There's not really much I can say there. Then it goes down to the base, which appears to be a Thornatus wheel, which is a very good base to use because it's solid. Makes a lot of sense. When I first saw this, I was just thinking that, you know, the rest of it's so solid. Why is there this base there? But really, if this is attached to something else, there's going to be something underneath that. So it's really not necessary for that to be filled in because, for one thing, I think it would be hard to fill in. So it's really not necessary in the first place. And, overall, that's about it. There's also this strange antenna thing that's poking up out of the Clementine. I have no idea what that is supposed to be. It's like, beep, boop, beep, boop. I'm a Clementine from outer space. I am here to take me to your fruit. I mean, leader, sandwich. Take me to your stove. I don't know. Either way, that would be the Citrus Ray by another than Fenrai. And, for those, by the time this episode is out in the poll, I will have posted the poll, which this and at least three other entries will compete for bragging rights in the contest. So, yeah. Have fun. Go vote if you want. Or just review it, or just look at it. I don't care. As long, whatever you do, don't listen to LJ. And that's it.
Oh, that was a very wise saying. Right there. I need to take that. No one ever listened to LJ.
You know, I must say, actually, take me to your stove. I'm pretty sure, even though I'm half fruit, I can dish out a better plate of puns than you can.
No, actually, that's not supposed to be a
shut
pun,
up,
at all.
Jay, shut up.
I agree.
I'm gonna be honest here.
If I had a tomato right here, I would throw it at you.
You want some fruit, LJ? Here, have some fruit. Throws fruit at LJ.
Look, I did not get that pun. I did not make up that pun. That's from The Far Side by Gary Larson, the old comic strip.
You made a bad decision by quoting.
Why? Far Side's awesome.
Yeah, it was very far to the side of what a good joke should be.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. It went too far outside
the time going through big chunks of the populace into paralytic confusion.
Anyway, moving on.
Yes.
Yeah. Well,
you guys are very punny, Jacob.
Who's gonna die next? Probably Venom.
Y'all. But yeah. So I suppose that wraps up this episode of TTV, and it was a pretty good one.
Alternate episode title, Take Me to Your Stove.
Take me to your stove. Anyway. But yeah. Thank you all for listening. Give feedback on the new format if you do so wish on our rubric page or our comments section. We appreciate your viewership, and I will talk to you next time.
Yep,
so I'm messing up.
I'm Broderin.
I'm LJ.
I'm Kai.
I'm Sumiki, and take me to your stove.
I'm Elena.
Who said nothing? As usual.
I'm always last. Venom.
And then
we need some antidote.
We kind of lost Kenium.
That was TTV episode, whatever. I don't even know.